Johann Wolfgang von Goethe said, "We can never directly see what is true, that is, identical with what is divine. We look at it only in reflection, in example, in the symbol, in individual and related phenomena. We perceive it as a life beyond our grasp, yet we cannot deny our need to grasp it." And seemingly the antithesis of this, Walt Whitman wrote, "I am the poet of reality. I say the earth is not an echo, nor man an apparition, but that all things seen are real, the witness and the albic dawn of things equally real. I have split the earth and the hard coal and rocks to the solid bed of the sea, and went down to meditate there a long time, and bring back a report. And I understand that those are positive and dense, every one, and that what they seem to a child they are, and that the world is not a joke, nor any part of it a sham." The impossible yet impassioned cries for objectivity over subjectivity, subjectivity over objectivity, have been voiced by the greatest poets and philosophers throughout the ages. Perhaps the paradoxical nature of the argument could best be summed up in the Zen koan that goes like so. A sage one day pronounces to a master that everyone has, in the end, their own truth. The master then quickly replies, "Oh, is that your truth?" Or, while crossing a bridge, which is somehow symbolic for the story, one person says to the other, "Look, those goldfish in the stream below sure are happy." The other person responds, "How do you know? You're not the fish." To which the first person replies, "How do you know I don't know? You're not me." So ultimately, in the absence of a resolution to this philosophical conundrum, I'll show images of famous and beautiful women.